Hi, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name's Lonnie, and I'm glad you could join me. What this video is going to be about is I hope to help you gain a better appreciation and more respect for the plants and what they can do for you. Gotta catch my breath. Okay, have you ever been out in the woods and slipped with your knife or cut yourself with your hatchet and you thought, oh crumb, I forgot my first aid kit, what am I gonna do? Well, that's where knowledge of the plants can come in handy. Let me show you a few plants that just might help. Okay, here's some plants that are very well known and quite widespread through the US and other parts of the world as well. Called plantain. You take the seed, the leaf here, and if you have an open wound, you make a spit poultice of the leaf and put that on the wound and hold it in place. That'll help it to heal quickly, help stop infection, and just help things to recover. Now here's another one right over here, another quite well known plant, yarrow. Again, take the leaves and wad these up and put them on the open wound. And not only is yarrow good for infection, stopping infection, helping a wound to heal, but yarrow is also very good for it's a coagulant. It helps blood to coagulate. If there's profuse bleeding and you're having trouble stopping the bleeding, try some yarrow on it. Now, you may be aware that plantain and yarrow both are common on disturbed soils. This is a power line clearing. And, so what if you're out in the middle of the woods? If you're out in the middle of the woods where there's no disturbed soils, you're probably not going to find much yarrow or plantain. What can you do then? Okay, come along with me and I'll show you. Okay, here's another one. Spruce pitch. If you're lucky enough to find the loose stuff that's still pretty loose, runny, like this, just take that and rub that on your wound. It's an excellent antiseptic. Now, what if you can't find any runny spruce pitch that's still loose? Well, I'll show you what to do. Okay, on our white spruce trees, they have bubbles on them. It's easier to see on these younger trees that are smoother bark. Like right here. What you do is just puncture that bubble. See that pitch that come out on my blade, that resin? Right there. That stuff is excellent for an antiseptic. And it works also as a bandage. A seal over your wound with this resin, and that'll help keep the dirt and stuff out of it. Now, here comes a story. I hope you guys like stories. It's hunting season here, so one of the neighbors is sighting in his rifle, so we'll just have to put up with it. Okay, I met a lady last year. She was telling me about how she had they had been out fishing. Their family had been out fishing, and she got a fish hook in her arm. And the fish hook had been in her son's fishing box, in the bottom of his box, and had been rolling around in there, and it was rusty, and it had, fish slime on it, and, the regular old stuff in the bottom of a fishing box. And so they were back in somewhere. She didn't say how far, but she got some devil's club root, mashed that up and put that on as a poultice for as an antiseptic to keep the infection down. Also, she got some watermelon root. Now, I'm not sure what she was talking about there. We have, that's my dog, Buck. We have here in Alaska what we call watermelon berry, or wild cucumber, or scoot berry, or twisted stalk. It's all the same plant. And that might have been what she was talking about. I don't know. But anyway, she got that, and she used spruce pitch. Okay, the next day she took it off, decided, well, it's been on there a while. She washed it off, and within a half hour, she said, she started getting red streaks going up her arms. She was getting blood poisoning. So she reapplied it, and when they finally got out to the doctor's office or hospital or wherever she went, the nurse took one look at that, and she says, oh, we got to get that stuff off of there. That's causing you problems. And the lady told the nurse, she says, ma'am, that's how I made it here. And, if she hadn't known about the wild plants and what to use and how to use it, the story might have ended up different, or they might have had some major medical complications. Okay, here's another one of my favorites. It grows all over here, right there. A lot of people call this old man's beard. What this is Usnea. There's quite a few different Usneas, and see, 14 of them, I believe, in Alaska. And okay, let's see if we can do this one-handed. How you can tell if it's Usnea is you pull it apart, and it'll have a string inside of it. Let's get another one. Okay. Pull it apart. There's a little one, but I need to find you a good one. So you can, okay, there's a good one right there. Hopefully you can see that white string that just pulled out of there. Right there on my fingernail. On the fingernail tip. Yeah. That defines it as Usnea. Usnea is an antiseptic. It's a antibacterial, antiviral, and antifungal. It's really useful stuff. It's kind of dusty feeling, and I've been using it for athlete's foot. Say you're out in the woods, you're on extended camping trip or whatnot, and you get athlete's foot, and you of course forgot to bring something, and wearing boots and perhaps crossing streams and stuff, your feet are wet and your toes are cracking and hurting and aching, and it's getting worse. This stuff right here will fix you up. It does me anyway. What I do is I dry it out, I get me a bundle of it. Here, let me get a few more pieces. Okay. Here we go. Okay, once it's dried out, then I hold it over my toes and I rub it together. There'll be some green dust come off of it. That's the fungus. A lichen is part fungus and part algae. The algae is that white string inside, and the fungus is the outside. Okay, I don't know if you can tell or not, but my fingers are kind of green right in here. It's from the dust. Okay, if you dust your toes with that, and in between your toes, rub it in, and then put some fresh dust on it, and put your socks on, dry socks. For me, it's one or two applications, my athlete's foot or fungal infection is gone. This is also excellent for, kind of twisting it up, bundling it up like that and putting it right on your wound. Or gather up a whole handful of it and put it on top of your wound as a bandage. To cover your wound, protect your wound. But this stuff will help heal your wound, help it to, it'll prevent infection, it'll kill the infection oftentimes. And in fact, this stuff has been medically proven to be effective against staph infection, MRSA, M-R-S-A. Now here comes another story. Some subscribers or viewers of my channel live up north. They wrote to me and told me about an experience they had with lichen. Now it's a lichen very similar to this, and they sent me a sample of it, and I haven't so far been able to identify it because I'm kind of new to lichens. It was not Usnea, but apparently it has medical property is very similar to Usnea. Anyway, he had knuckle surgery and in Anchorage, and he went back home, and the surgery just was not healing, and so they put him through, he thought, 3 or 4 or 5 rounds of different antibiotics, and it just wasn't working. Finally, they diagnosed him as having MRSA and MRSA. And he thought, well, conventional medicine's not helping me. He remembered reading in a book about tree lichens. So he went out and he got some of that green lichen. It looks very similar to this. And he dusted it into his cut, and he put, like I showed you, you know, being on his knuckle, you know, every time his knuckle bent like that, it would open up the cut. Well, he just rolled up some of it and stuffed it into the incision and changed it several times. And I forget now how long he said. I think he said like a week. It was quite healed up, and the doctors were very surprised at the lack of scarring. Typically, there's a lot more scarring in that type of a surgery. Okay, let's go on. I'll show you some others.